We're going back to open lines here shortly. God, here's an interesting fact. I'm getting a lot of interesting faxes. It's from Sandy, and I won't give her last name, though. She gives it here. Hi, Art. I have an audio tape message of a ghost. I am a God-fearing woman and do not like pranks, so I assure you this is no prank. I once lived in a very haunted house and would love to share my tape and history. If you're interested, I have an email, gives email address, or my home phone, she gives a phone number. Love your program, always been a faithful listener and seeker of truth for several years. Best wishes always, Sandy, and I won't give her last name. I think I'm going to call Sandy right now. See if this is true. God-fearing, huh? Okay. Nothing like doing it right here on the air. Let me see if I can do this. See if we can get a ring.
Hello?
Sandy, it's
yes,
Art.
Yes, I heard on the radio.
Okay, then you know it's Art Bell and you know you're on the air, right?
Yes, I do.
All right, you really have a tape of a ghost?
Yes, I do.
Do you have it to where you could play it on, you know, like hold your phone up to the tape recorder and play it?
Yeah, I've got it set just in case you would have called, so.
All right. First, then, tell us a little bit of the history about what we're going to hear. When did you get this? How'd you get it? What happened?
Well, it's been about 10 years ago, and we lived in a house. My daughter was 11 or 12 at the time, and kind of so nervous.
Just relax.
Anyway, she...
Where was this?
This was in Oroville, California.
Oroville, California. All right.
I'm living in Washington now.
All right.
And she kept telling me that she heard knocking on the wall in this house. And I said, no. I'm not going to have any ghost business, and I don't want to hear this stuff. And,
yeah.
Her and her little friend were in her room, and they had one of those real small little radios, you know, you give a kid.
Sure.
Record tapes. And her and her friend would record, you know, a fantasy story. Well, one day they had recorded a story on the tape, and they went to play it, and there was something else on the tape before their story started. On the original tape, it actually was on the part that wasn't even magnetized. It was on that little, you know, that little trailer that starts the tape.
You're kidding.
No. And when I heard the, she, you know, excitedly brought it to me, and I played it, and I played it again, and I played it again, and then I got terrified. And a lot of things happened in that house after that. I got angry with the ghost and told it to leave us alone.
Did that work?
Well, it basically left me alone. My son was in his room and in his bed, and as his bed was being dragged across the floor.
What? What?
Yeah. And,
Now, you're not a drinker? You're not a drug user?
Oh, absolutely not. I'm about as grounded as I come.
You saw your son's bed being dragged with him in it?
Well, he was awake. And he told me about it, and I went into his room and saw that his bed was actually 3 feet from where
it had been.
It normally was. And he had been laying in it, you know, he had gone to bed, been laying there a couple of minutes, and the bed just started sliding across the floor.
Sandy.
I slept in a water bed, and at night, every once in a while, the water in it would just start churning like it was an egg beater inside the mattress. And it was kind of like...
Now, I sleep in a waterbed, Sandy, and the last thing I want to think about is something down in the water. Oh, my God.
Turning it, yeah. But it was like he just played these little jokes, you know,
uh-huh.
Little things, like an exercise bike and just start spinning the wheels or...
Oh, humorous.
...would knock on the walls every once in a while.
Yeah.
And one day I was looking in a cupboard, and it knocked out, you know, that shave and a haircut.
Yeah, yeah.
And I didn't knock back, and so it knocked back real hard, you know, that last little dut dut. It just slammed it into the wall.
I experienced that once here several months ago in the studio, Sandy. I'm telling you the truth now. All of a sudden, there was a crash on my door. I mean, I've got a studio inside my home. Uh-huh. And there is nobody here. Some cats, right?
Uh-huh.
And they were all asleep on the bed with my wife. And, of course, I didn't know that at the time. But, I mean, it's like in the movies where you see that horrible crash and a door bends inward. I'm not saying it bent inward. It didn't. But, I mean, I thought, my God, 200 pounds just hit that door. It was a big crash. And I ran over and opened the door, and there was absolutely nothing there. Ran across the house into the bedroom. My wife was asleep with all three cats sitting right there. So I know about these horrible knocks and bangs.
Same ghost, maybe.
Scare the you-know-what out of me.
Yeah.
All right, why don't you play this for us?
It sounds really deep, and the first few times I heard it, I had to listen several times before I really realized what he was saying. But I'm going to play.
Oh, you mean there's a voice?
It's a voice.
All right.
He left this voice message on the tape.
All right. Play it. Just play it first without telling us.
Okay, here goes.
Let's see what we've got here.
Diana?
Oh, my goodness. All right, now rewind it. And this time, tell me what you think. Now, you've listened many times. We have not. What do you think it says?
Let me tell you first?
Yeah, go ahead and tell us now.
He says, I wish we were together.
Oh, all right, play it again. Oh, God, that is what it says. This is like listening to David Oates in reverse speech, you know.
I know, maybe you could reverse it.
It's exactly.
No, it really sounds strange.
Oh, you know? Sandy.
It's got that clicking noise in the back.
Oh, Sandy, rewind it one last time. There is no question about it. It says, I wish we were together. So, do you have any idea of who that is, Sandy?
Absolutely not. But we did find out after, you know, the house was kind of active, and my daughter went, and she had a little friend there in the neighborhood, and her mother said that there was a murder and a suicide in that house. And it had happened in, there was two bathrooms, and it had happened in one of the bathrooms. Well, I had always never felt alone in that one bathroom. I never used it because I always felt something else there.
I hear you. Now that is creepy. That is really creepy.
Isn't it? It just makes the hair stand up. You know, I'm used to it now, but it used to just make my hair stand up.
Well, I'm not. So play it one last time. Hit it one last time. I want to listen very carefully. Oh, Sandy.
Rich, huh?
I'll tell you, and then what follows. In other words, what you've got on there is
What comes after is my daughter's voice.
I understand. I heard that. But
yes.
There's the leader is what you're talking about. There's nothing on the leader.
Yeah.
The minute the leader is over, then this comes on, and then whatever your daughter was doing is on after that.
Right. It's like it just moved everything over, and this voice was just there.
Well, I would have totally freaked out. In fact, I would have called.
Did.
did you get in touch with anybody? Did you consult an exorcist?
No, I contemplated for a couple of days of calling a Catholic priest or something, you know, to rid the house of this entity, but I ended up just getting really mad. And I just stood there and I just said, you know, you leave us alone. When you start paying rent on this house, then you can haunt it. But until then, leave us alone. And my kids just like, Mom! I did not want my kids all sleeping in the on the couches because they were afraid of their rooms and that kind of thing.
I don't blame them.
And so
I would be too. Sandy, would you do me a gigantic favor?
Sure.
And can you mail me a dub, one generation off the original?
Sure, you can.
You can?
Yep. Your address is on the website, right?
Yes, it is, and I'll give it to you now if you want it.
I don't have a pen.
All right, then I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Get it right off the website.
Tell you what I'm
going to
do. I'll get a piece of paper and a pencil. When I come back after the top of the hour, I'll give my address just to be sure you get it. All right?
Okay.
All right, Sandy. Bless your heart. Thank you.
Thank you, Art.
And you take care.
I will.
All right. Bye. Oh, man. That's Sandy now in Washington. And anybody out there have any comments on that one?